In this film, I'll be taking the train from London St. Pancras to Disneyland Resort Paris in order to see the story of an untold story of one soldier in the Empire who is in charge of Inferno Squad named Iden Versio.
Safety information cards could be found at each coach. Thank you. Mesdames et messieurs de Eurostar destination de Disneyland de Paris, c'est un petit espace sur la porte, vous allez porter dans le bagage, je compte sur vous. Pas du côté de sécurité, quand c'est choisi, si on choisit chaque voiture.
It departed at 10:14, forming a service 9074 Eurostar service to Disneyland Paris. It will call at Epsfleet and Ashford. Pick up only those passengers who want to go to Disneyland Paris. All the porters at Disneyland Paris will take all those luggage with them to each one of the residential hotels, one of the Disney hotels around the park.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome aboard this Eurostar service to Disneyland Paris. In 50 minutes, more passengers will be joining us at Epsfleet and some more passengers joining us at Ashford International. Please make sure you are in the great seats. If you like something to eat or drink, head to the Cafe Metropolitan coaches 8 and 9. Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue aboard. C'est le Eurostar destination de Disneyland Paris. Donc, bienvenue de voyageurs rentrés à Epsfleet et Eurostar à Ashford International. Mes secondes liens sont en place, cachées au jour de billets. Les bases des cabines métropolitaines voitures 8 et 9 sont faites discrètes sur l'expansion.
We now run non-stop through Stratford International. The flyover linking to Temple Mills diverges off, which is joined up with the other line, which is towards London. Stratford International is an interchange for the DLR routes alongside the line to Woolwich Arsenal. We now emerging to daylight alongside the Raiden Marshes, I presume coming alongside the C2C mainline from Tilbury. We cross the Channel Tunnel and arrive at Marne-la-Vallée-Chassé for Disneyland Paris, where I got off the train and the porters will take some of the labelled luggage to their nearby hotel. But whilst I'm in the hotel, I now unpack the bags and go into the interactive area around Disneyland Paris. To Star Wars Center in Discoveryland. Into Star Wars Battlefront 2, we saw Luke Skywalker helping the Rebel Alliance to defeat the Empire in hope of freedom to the galaxy. Here he fought Darth Maul, which believed to be dead, but not existed anymore. and this is the Millennium Falcon, flying in amongst the debris of the Death Star at Endor system. The Millennium Falcon is the Corellian YT-1300 that was once owned by Lando Calrissian before Han took over from the Sabacc. And this is the duel of a Skywalker. Darth Vader, once known as Anakin Skywalker, duels with his son, Luke Skywalker, who is destined to become a Jedi like his father before him. His green lightsaber was made by himself, long after his blue lightsaber was his father's legacy lightsaber, which has been lost in Bespin, when Vader reveals that he was his father. And on to the story. About one of the important stories with the Imperial commander named Iden Versio. And this was her droid called an ID-10, later to be known as Dio, not to be confused with the green conical droid in The Rise of Skywalker. In fact, it was a seeker droid, which has been used by the Galactic Empire, similar to other ones, including the probe droids, which they used in the Imperial Elite. Contact me when it's done. The ID-10 frees Iden Versio out of the cell.
Let's go.
For our attack on Endor, join us. This is Admiral Akbar calling the Invincible Faith as he instructed the Empire's attention from Sullust and massing the fleet above Endor to mount a surprise attack against the Imperial Elite. But Iden Versio had no choice but to retrieve the Imperial message and to force an attack against the Rebel Alliance. And that creates an incursion. She ejects out into space, vacuum from the airlock. And there is their headquarters called the Corvus, an Imperial Raider II class corvette. She took off her helmet and then zoomed away into hyperspace. This is Agent Gideon Hask, who has served under the Empire. He was once from Coat Corporation, where the company they built and established those Star Destroyers. of the Imperial Elite.
Remember the Jabez incursion?
Still haunts my dreams.
Contact the Admiral.
Yes, Commander. And the message?
The fleet's location is still safe. Today, the Rebellion dies.
And this is the Battle of Endor from a different point of view, from Inferno Squad's point of view, rather than from the Rebellion.
Get me Inferno Squad now.
The Executor crashed into the Death Star, the second Death Star, which is located on the Endor system. And this is what happens when the Death Star exploded.
Okay. Those can't be all of them. Those rebel commanders must have already moved on.
We should too.
We're near platform 4.
Is there a shuttle there?
No, TIE fighters only.
Even better.
We should move carefully. We don't know how many rebels are out here.
No, we'll deal with them the same as the rest. Today we wipe out that scum once and for all.
Look alive, agents. We can grieve later. Right now, we need to move.
On you, Commander.
They plan to evacuate Endor along with the remnants of the Imperials via getting the TIE fighters from Platform 4 at the Endor moon. And this is all that remains of the Death Star. One of them will be going to one of the oceanic moons called Kethbir, which it will be later to be discovered by the Resistance, so where to find one object called the Sith Wayfinder, the compasses that leads to Exegol. The spirit, although the Emperor is dead in the second Death Star, his spirit retreats to Exegol, which is located in the unknown regions.
Someone told me once that rebellions are built on hate. I never stopped believing it.
How are we supposed to fight that?
The Empire will change, just like it did when they destroyed the first Death Star. We adapt or die.
Commander, we have a problem.
What is it, Hap?
The Corvus was damaged by the Death Star explosion. Engines are down, but the crew is making repairs.
Get the rendezvous coordinates from the Admiral.
Commander, I'm picking up quite a few ship signals outside the debris field.
Any of them Imperial?
Not many. They've either retreated or been destroyed.
What about the Admiral Star Destroyer?
The Eviscerator is positioned near the Corvus. It appears to be fully functional.
At least Hask isn't alone on the Corvus. We might actually make it out of this alive.
Del Miko, her partner, along with Gideon Hask, rejoins up with the Corvus, and there was a problem. There were bombers going to make an attack run on the Corvus, but they had to clear off the rebel attacks in order to get clear for the escape from Endor. Imperial Commander Iden Versio joins up with his father, Admiral Garrick Versio, on the planet called Vardos to make a brief about what they can do next.
You wish to see me, sir?
Approach. The Emperor is dead.
So what happens now?
We retaliate, Commander. The Empire will assault the very foundation of the rebels' pathetic belief in themselves. Tell me, Aiden, what is the source of their belief?
hope.
Correct. This messenger's presence is a great honor, one I choose to share with my daughter.
Admiral Versio, Operation Cinder is to begin at once. Resistance, rebellion, defiance. These are concepts that cannot be allowed to persist. You are but one of many tools by which these ideas shall be burned away. Heed my messenger. He shall lead you to your target.
Operation Cinder is the last command of our Emperor, and the first step in securing our future. Inferno is crucial to its success.
What's our target?
You are not verified.
That information can wait. For now. Here are next assignments. They are unusual. But these are unusual times. Go, Commander. Do what you do best.
Suddenly, there was a rebel attack on the Fondor shipyards, and they had to find a way to disrupt the ion cannons from inside the MC-80 Star Cruiser of the Rebel Fleet. Although this is going to plan, the detonation sequence is detonate the blockade runner, and it's crushed into it to make a vacuum in order to prevent it sucking into the outer space. But luckily, her droid closed the shield just at precise the right time. Easy come, easy go. Then Iden Versio released the docking clamps that locks the Star Destroyer called the Dauntless. As you all know, the Star Destroyer Dauntless is also seen in Rogue One as it hovers above Jeddah City, before it's been destroyed by the first Death Star, which has been destroyed in the Battle of the Abyss. The Dauntless destroys the Rebel MC-80 Star Cruiser, which is overseas by Commander Moff Wraith. Then Agent Delmica was tracked as he went to a mission at Pilial, as he met Luke Skywalker, the last of the Jedi Knights. Although the Jedi's been destroyed by Order 66 when the rise of the Empire and Darth Vader. He was his son, as mentioned earlier, as I talked about earlier, Luke Skywalker helped the Rebel Alliance to restore a new hope, along with his sister Leia Organa. In this mission, this is Luke Skywalker after the Battle of Endor, when he tried to save his father, but sacrificed himself as he died to kill the Emperor.
Come on. We need to work together if we're gonna get out of here.
Estelle activated the defense systems around the mantle of the planet. It upsets the wildlife, including some of the most vicious bugs and insects called Skritters. and this is Operation Cinder. Operation Cinder targets some of the most planets that have disrupted with most of the Imperial leadership.
Lower your weapon.
Defiance will be the death of you.
They have fallen apart during the destruction of Vardos, and they too defected to the Rebel Alliance. Del and Iden. They rejoin the rebellion in hope to restore peace to the galaxy. To serve better than helping with the Imperials. They've hijacked an all-terrain armored transport, or AT-AT for short, as they go towards the course, and then they escaped Vardos to escape Operation Cinder satellites. They surrounded the planet, and then they come up with a plan to help the rebellion save all those planets from the Cinder satellites. Meanwhile, Iden flows nowadays an X-Wing rather than a TIE fighter. Instead, it's a T-65 X-Wing. With the squadron called Danger Squad, led by the Duros named Shrift Shergav. They went to Naboo to destroy those Cinder satellites, and in order to save the galaxy from the Imperials, they're gonna fight the what remains of the Empire. It's their only cause. It's now a battle of hope as much as strength.
Do we have any satellites left? We'll handle the last of them. You take care of that Star Destroyer.
Key reinforcements are here. Why would
they took down the Imperial Star Destroyer, but although it's been destroyed, some of the surviving Imperials took those Imperial troopers, and of course those walkers, down to feed of Naboo, in order to destroy them, the town of Theed. This is known as the Emperor's home planet. But not only that, Princess Leia was there, and there was the very place where her late mother, Padme Amidala, was queen at that time, and later senator, along with her allies, Senator Bail Organa, adopted Leia Organa in the House of Alderaan, and it was destroyed before the Battle of Yavin. And this is what they're gonna do to fight to destroy the most of the Imperials with an ion pulse come from the palace itself. The ion disruptors disabled her little ID-10 droid, and it was deactivated.
People like you.
And Princess Leia transitions to hope from the Rebel Alliance hope into something new.
Is the reason we're going to win. Welcome to the New Republic. Thank you, ma'am.
They modified the Corvus with new powerful engines and with various modifications. They went off to Takodana to a distress call for Han Solo.
If you bring the Empire to my doorstep...
You know I always cover my tracks. Come on now, help me out. Help Chewie.
I don't know your man, but it is late. And you may find that this crowd is... talkative.
Thank you. Thanks, Maz. I owe you one.
You owe me more than that, Han Solo. And don't you forget it.
Roddy, good to see you.
Listen, pal, I'm looking for a friend named Paldora. You know him?
After you left me stranded during the Zerka job? Not a chance.
Come on, it all worked out. It must have, because here you are.
Back off. Find your Paldora on your own. You two can talk about your stupid beards.
So he's a bearded guy. Got it. Hey, Mr. Paldora. Long time no see. My Wookiee pal was just asking about you.
You must be confusing me with that insufferable man upstairs.
My mistake. You know, you look just like a friend of mine, name of Paldora.
You think I look like that idiot drinking Marinzane gold?
He can afford to drink Marinzane gold?
Must be nice, right?
I can order a drink in Wookiee speak.
Han Solo! I'm Imperial Specialist Ralsius Paldora. It is a pleasure to finally meet you.
Shh, you want to keep it down?
Oh, right, right. Because we're meeting incognito.
Come on, we need to get you out of here.
Off we go, then.
Oddly enough, most statisticians are killed by apprentice statisticians. Oh dear.
Friends of yours?
I assume this is your fault?
Usually is.
What's my number one rule, Solo?
No fighting. Come on. We gotta move.
One of Han Solo's next missions is to take Paldora to the Millennium Falcon in order to take him up to the Republic fleet to save the Wookiees, to liberate them from Kashyyyk, from the Empire, and the Wookiees are freed at last.
This'll be loud!
Shouldn't we get to the ship?
Times more often than the 2400.
Chewie, get him out of my cockpit.
No, wait, I'll behave.
Admiral Galactic Versio had deployed some operations on both Bespin and Sullust. At first, they had to go to Bespin in order to track down Hask, to find and capture him.
We've got searchlights all over the city.
Hask will be in the Overseer's Tower on Chinook Station. Better stick to the clouds so they don't spot us.
Where is everyone?
Did you really think it would be so easy?
Hask.
We picked up the Corvus the second it slipped through the blockade. If it were up to me, I'd deal with you personally. But I have responsibilities now. And taking care of you is no longer one of them. Goodbye, Iden.
No, no, no! We can't let him get away!
That Star Destroyer! That must be Hask's.
So much for that plan.
They took a cloud car in order to stop the refinery to make a chain reaction that will bring down the Imperial Star Destroyers. Plummeted to the abyss below. The important mission for Shriv is to join up with Lando Calrissian to steal the weapons and shut down the factory. But instead, Lando has a plan. He shut down the engine at the factory, but that doesn't seem to work.
Yes.
Why? What are you gonna do?
Improvise. You just find us a ride out of here.
Whatever gets me farthest from you.
Then his next plan is to melt down and overload the pump systems. And then they melt all the weapon systems rather than stealing the weapons from the factory itself.
You're running the factory with lava?
No, I'm shutting it down.
With lava? What about the weapons? Ike wants them for the Republic.
I'll apologize later. We can't let the Empire have these weapons.
Attention all personnel. Lava suspension rate increasing. Attention at risk.
My position of walker just right. I should be able to cross over. That didn't work. Maybe it's this button. Time for this. Good enough for me. Trev, did you find us a ride?
New plan. Meet me in the back near the assembly line. Look, I'm taking another enormous risk.
I could kiss you.
They hijacked an AT-ST to go to the landing platforms to get a pickup from the Corvus.
If I die here, I'm glad you will too.
Well, thank you, buddy.
Their next mission is to go to Jakku to fight off what remains of the Empire, which is the final battle of the Galactic Civil War between the New Republic and the Empire.
Carabast. I'm picking up distress calls. Too many to count.
Del, the Corvus is yours. Cover the sky. Shriv and I will help on the ground.
Hold on a moment. Iden. Make sure you come back.
Make sure I have a ship to come back to.
Hey, Shriv, I hope you survive this incredibly dangerous mission as well. Thank you, Del. Your friendship means everything to me.
Their first mission is to go to Carbon Ridge to deploy and to set a chain reaction that would destroy the entire hangar full of Thai bombers to extract some of the Imperial ones, and then help Captain Lindsay prior to an evacuation because of the downed blockade runner shot down by the Imperial walkers, and Del Mico help the escape on the Corvus. Bad news, Gideon Hask, and along with Admiral Garrett Versio that hit her father, have found the Corvus in Jakku. He tried to rescue her father, but she can't. He couldn't resist an escape. So Iden travels alone in order to get off the Star Destroyer, the Eviscerator. He gets on the escape pod in order to get out. Minutes later, Del picked up a distress call from the escape pod. Decades later, a new dark threat looms in the galaxy as those surrender their might. It's become known as the First Order. The First Order controls major systems now throughout the galaxy. But a new hope was to be on the horizon, created by General Leia Organa and called the Resistance, in order to stop the First Order. Kylo Ren, which is once known as Ben Solo, the son of General Leia and Han Solo, interrogates Del Mico of where they find the map. Skywalker. Of where Lord Senteca took the map to Bayora.
I have what I came for. He's yours now. Clean this up.
And finally, Hask was there. He survived the crash on Jakku.
How are you doing? You spare me the pleasantries, Hask. We both know how this ends.
Yeah, and you don't get to be brave! Because you are not a soldier anymore!
Look at you, you're a coward. You traded in your weapon. For what? Fatherhood. All in cargo on the Corvus.
You know, Iden may have betrayed me, but you, Del, you let me down! You...
We all change, don't we? Hey? And look at you. You used to be dead.
Well, Iden could do just about anything except kill me. Apparently.
Ask. Gideon! Please. Don't go after her. It won't end well for you. Please.
Project Resurrection can continue as planned.
On the contrary, Clem. I sought you out because you were useful to me once. We rebuilt your home and we allowed Janata Security to maintain control of the system, but in return you have fallen behind schedule and you have allowed an outsider to discover our plan.
An honest mistake, I assure you. My men will relocate the Pinio operation and triple our efforts on Athula.
Well, I shall leave behind a few of my men to see that you do. Make sure you bury Delmico and his crew. But leave the Corvus alone.
You know it will lead her back here.
I'm planning on it.
The Resistance is about to make some of the new updated model X-Wings called the T-70. Similar model but streamlined than the Rebel Alliance's predecessors. And the TIE Fighters are too modernized with a slightly different appearance to that of the Imperials, which is all black rather than silvery grey. Even Kylo Ren has a prototype fighter called the TIE Silencer. And along with his command shuttle. And this is Kylo Ren fighting the Resistance. And this is a girl of hope. Little do we know that Rey was in fact a granddaughter of the Emperor Palpatine.
Where are they?
Palpatine was hidden always in Exegol. She fought the stormtroopers on board the Resurgent Star Destroyer, which is a sleeker, more bigger than the Imperial predecessors. She fought Captain Phasma, as Kylo Ren fought the Resistance. Oops. In order to defend Starkiller Base from letting the Resistance destroying it, for Poe Dameron to do that work for them. Starkiller Base was once a planet called Ilum, as they converted by the Empire. When the First Order took over, they adopted the name Starkiller Base with a system-killing weapon.
Something's coming. Something's horrible.
This is once her homeworld called Jakku, which is a planet full of littered and ruined Star Destroyers from one of the days of the old Empire. She fought her grandfather, the Emperor. She was revenge made flesh. She fought Kylo Ren and was known as the Duel of a Dyad in the Force. Two that are one. This will become known as the Power of Two. Between the light and dark sides of the Force. She dueled Ben Solo, since he was once known. And this is one of the bravest of droids in the Resistance, BB-8, one of the most bravest of droids. Once belonged to Poe Dameron, and now are befriended with Ray and Finn. And inside was a part of the map to Luke Skywalker, which O retrieved it. And he said, "You can take this, it'll be safer in you. You get away as far away as you can, and I'll come back for you." That's what Poe said to BB-8 at Bakatwanor Village. BB-8 defeated Kylo Ren at last. And this is more Rey. She helped defend the command post, and then she fought Kylo Ren.
At least I won't be around.
Unexpectedly behind her.
You know this is wrong.
A Knight of Ren is once known. Was no Sith. He was an alchemist from the world of Exegol, created by Palpatine himself. Palpatine also made Snoke.
Now.
Finally, the Battle of Dakar, with all the X-Wing fighting the TIE fighters. I managed to take out some of the TIE fighters. If I am a pilot, I will take my droid onto the socket and into battle to fight the TIE fighters. Fight the TIE fighters in order to restore freedom to the galaxy.
System support looks dire.
I locked on using proton torpedoes. And the TIE fighters goes platoon into nothingness. After the battle, I then get the Eurostar train 9081 back to London St Pancras International, which call it Ashford and Ebbsfleet. First of all via Lille, then Ashford and Ebbsfleet. Then we leave Ebbsfleet to join up with the High Speed 1 as we come alongside the route from Tilbury. We then speed alongside the marshy lands of Raynham in Essex as we come closer towards London. We then descended into tunnels and speeding through Stratford International. Stratford International is always served by southeastern Japanese, but not really an international station used by Eurostars though anymore. And is also the nearest station to the nearby Olympic Park, home of the 2012 Games, and is nearby the London Stadium, the current home of West Ham United Football Club. And at last, we arrive at London St Pancras International.
Please make sure you keep all your belongings with you when you leave the train. If you want to make sure you go to the taxis, please go to the very front of the station or near King's Cross Station. If you want to go to London King's Cross, change your for services to the north. On behalf of the team, we wish you a very pleasant day and hope to see you again on Eurostar. Mesdames et messieurs, la bienvenue à Londres. Ce train de voiture de train de voiture de train de redirection de bagages se compte de train de taxi de 60 Londres King's Cross. Et ordre de keeper de voiture de voyage de sponsor de stop. Merci.
As if on cue, a Brussels-bound Eurostar service departs at platform 11. I hope that the Force was with me as I've been to Disneyland Paris. Long memories, since a year ago, I've been there, but only for one night at the hotel due to the upcoming coronavirus. Me and Artemita went there exactly a year ago. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, Williams Group 91. And may the Force be with you always.